My name is Adam Stivers. I've been an attorney since 2011. In June of 2018, I realized that the anxiety and depression caused by my practice was leading me to become suicidal. It was at that time I decided to close my practice and focus on myself. Since then, I've been working on my mental and physical health. Attorney suicide has become a crisis of epidemic proportions. This is being recognized not only by our Illinois State Bar Association, but by the American Bar Association as well. They say 1 in 10 attorneys has had suicidal thoughts. Attorneys also suffer anxiety and depression at a rate 5 to 6 times higher than the general population. There are many reasons why attorneys are suffering. Long work hours is one of them. New associates are sometimes required to bill over 1,900 hours a year. A traditional work year is only 2,000 hours. No one can bill every hour of every day. That means that new associates are often working 4,000 or 6,000 hours every year. That adds up to 60 or 80 hour weeks. There's also increased competition. In the Great Recession of 2008, many people decided to go to law school as a way to ride out 3 years of the Great Recession. That means that there are many more attorneys now than there ever were before. Also, automation from computers has reduced the required number of attorneys. So we're dealing with an increase in attorneys and a decrease in attorney demand. That's created competition that has made the profession pretty cutthroat. There's also the pressure of perfection. In the practice of law, you can make mistakes, but those mistakes might end your entire career. You might catch a malpractice case, the discipline committee might be contacted, and after 20 or 30 years of building a business, you might not have a law license. That's a lot of stress. Some remedies for attorneys include therapy, medication, and reducing the stigma of mental health among attorneys. We really have to talk to one another. We have to let each other know that it's okay to feel stressed out, it's okay to be anxious, it's okay to sometimes even be depressed, but it's not okay to have suicidal thoughts. If we're dealing with these things, and we are, we need to be honest with ourselves and with each other. My personal experience revealed the problem of student loan debt to be one of the worst issues among new attorneys. Bullying is also a problem in the profession. Many partners feel that they have to bully the associates into making them good attorneys. That's because that's how it was done in the past. People of my generation and below, though, we were taught not to bully one another. So bullying doesn't work for us. It makes us upset and it makes us depressed. There's also dissatisfaction with the profession itself. Automation has eliminated a great portion of this job. And if you've spent a decade learning estate planning, wills, trusts, real estate transactions, and business creation like I have, you might know that computer forms have completely replaced that entire wing of the profession. In order to progress through my mental and physical health problems, I began a practice of meditation. Meditation has helped me to calm my mind and center myself so that I'm able to confront my problems and move through them. Creating a community of open discussion revolving around our problems of anxiety and depression and even suicide is the only route to lowering the stigma of mental health issues and allowing us to cure that problem and move towards positive outcomes. Thanks for watching this quick takes video from the Illinois State Bar Association. I really appreciate your attention, and I hope that this begins a conversation with you and all of the attorneys you know.